Welcome back guys. In this set of video lectures, I'll be talking about DNA replication process in prokaryotes and eukaryotes. Firstly, I'll start with introduction part. DNA replication. It's the biological process of producing two identical replicas, that is copy of DNA, from one original DNA molecule during cell division. It occurs in all living organisms and it's the basis for biological inheritance. Why does DNA replication need to occur? As we all know, DNA is the genetic material that defines every cell. And in organisms, cells duplicate and divide into new daughter cells through mitosis or meiosis. In this process, biomolecules and organelles must be copied to be distributed among the cells. Same goes with DNA, which must be replicated in order to ensure that each cell receives the correct number of chromosomes. This process of DNA duplication is called DNA replication. In eukaryotic cells, such as animal cell and plant cell, DNA replication occurs in S phase of interphase during the cell cycle. The DNA replication is vital for cell growth, repair, and reproduction. There were three models for how organisms might replicate their DNA: conservative, semi-conservative, dispersive. First one is conservative. In this model, DNA replication results in one molecule that consists of both original DNA strands, that is identical to the original DNA molecule. As you can see in this picture, same blue color strands. And another molecule that consists of two new strands with exactly the same sequence as the original molecule. As you can see in this picture, new yellow color bent strands. Semi-conservative. In this model, the two strands of DNA unwind from each other and each acts as a template for synthesis of a new complementary strand. This results in two DNA molecules with one original strand and one new strand. As you can see in this picture, in first replication, blue strand indicates parent DNA strand and yellow strand indicates new daughter DNA strand. Dispersive. In this model, DNA replication results in two DNA molecules that are mixture or hybrids of parental and daughter DNA. In this model, each individual strand is a patchwork of original and new DNA. Most biologists supported semi-conservative model of replication as this model supported the double helix DNA structure. In the end, Meselson and Stahl cracked the puzzle. Let me explain you their experiment. Meselson and Stahl experiment. In 1958, they supported Watson and Crick's hypothesis that DNA replication was semi-conservative. They conducted an experiment on DNA replication using E.coli bacteria. Firstly, they grew E.coli in medium containing heavy isotope of nitrogen N15. The bacteria took up the nitrogen and used it to synthesize new biological molecules including DNA. As you can see in first tube, 100% heavy DNA with N15 isotope of nitrogen. Then they switched E.coli into medium containing light N14 isotope of nitrogen. As you can see, tube 3 and 4 shows 50% hybrid N15 N14 DNA and 50% light N14 N14 DNA, which clearly explains semi-conservative mode of replication, meaning that each strand in DNA molecule serves as a template for synthesis of new complementary strand. Here is the difference between DNA replication in prokaryotes and eukaryotes. In prokaryotes, replication occurs inside cytoplasm, and in eukaryotes, it occurs inside nucleus. In prokaryotes, there is only one origin of replication, but in eukaryotes, there are many origins of replication, over 1000. Replicon. Here, replicon means it's a unit of DNA in which replication starts from an origin and proceeds bidirectionally or unidirectionally to terminus sites is called replicon. This replicon is circular and monorepliconic in prokaryotes and linear and multi-repliconic in eukaryotes. One replication bubble formed in prokaryotes, but in eukaryotes, many replication bubbles formed. Okazaki fragments are large in prokaryotes, that is 1000 to 2000 nucleotides long. These fragments are short in eukaryotes, that is 100 to 200 nucleotides long. Replication is very rapid in prokaryotes, that is 2000 base pair per second, but in eukaryotes it's slow, that is 100 base pair per second. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe my channel.